The perfect crime is about to be committed, and Jeffrey Brenner is caught in the middle. The museum is the scene of the crime, and someone in this room did it. Is it the director, the curator, her associate, the head security guard, or the society matron? Match wits with Jeffrey and see if you can find out who done it.
The South Bay Museum of Natural History, where the largest diamond in the world, the Zertigo diamond, is on special exhibition. While on its national tour, this 564-carat white diamond has attracted more attention than any other previous museum showing. Museum officials estimate by the time the exhibition closes, a record 3.5 million people will have viewed this gorgeous gem. You know, Jess, I'm not sure whether there's more sparkle and flash happening outside the museum or in.
Really is an incredible thing. I can't wait to show you the security system. Even you are going to be impressed. The museum had it especially designed for the exhibit. First of all, it takes a key to turn off the alarm. That's the lock. But even that won't open up the case. What it takes is a voice saying the right code words. That's the microphone.
Yeah, but any bozo can figure out the secret code words.
Wrong, kiddo. They're not secret. The catch is the voice has to match the voice print already programmed into the equipment. I tell you what, the alarm isn't set yet, so why don't you see if your voice can open the case? The code words are, and you're gonna love this one.
Zertigo diamond.
Good. Try it.
The Zertigo diamond.
The Zertigo diamond.
I am impressed.
2 points for my side.
Mom?
Yeah?
Think you'd be okay if I touched it?
Jeffrey, it's really breathtaking. Must be the size of a baseball. Oh, it's like a piece of the sun.
Yeah, but it's cool and smooth. It's got so many sides. It's the size of a softball, Mom. Jeez, this thing must be worth a fortune.
Well, ain't chopped liver.
How you doing, Sam?
Some piece of ice, huh, sweetheart?
Sure is.
Gentlemen, I hate to cut this short, but I've got to get changed for the reception, and I have to get you something to eat. Okay. So what do you want for supper?
Steak, french fries, chocolate cake, chicken, pizza.
Your beans are at 9 o'clock. You gonna eat them or not?
Not.
Oh. All right, my dear. Then I will. I just realized what I miss so much about not being married to your father anymore. Having someone who can cook around the house. I must be seeing things. This is not the Nicolesio I work with. Not in a tuxedo.
Nick in a tuxedo? I'll believe it when I see it.
Very funny.
How you doing, Nick? A southpaw.
What?
Nick's left-handed.
Well, yeah, but how do you know that?
You wear your watch on the right hand. Right-handed people wear their watch on the left hand.
He gets his brilliance from my side of the family, of course.
Margaret, I have your key for you.
Are you all right?
As I was saying, I have your key, Margaret. Oh, and yours too, Nick. These are the alarm system shut-off keys. As you know, we are the only three who have them. This is yours, Nick. Only our three voices are programmed into the system's computer and can open the case. Margaret? I'm sure I needn't remind you of our responsibilities. I don't want anything to go wrong tonight. Oh, and Nick, you still haven't brought me my gloves. Oh, and you'd better find a pair for yourself as well.
Yes, sir.
Bye, Mr. Emerson.
Oh, Jeffrey. I hear you've won another reward for your sculpture. Excellent.
Excellent. Isn't His Excellency carrying it a little too far?
You know, you never told me that this job included the responsibility of acting as his valet. Come on, now. You're not going to leave me alone in all this, are you? Are you sure you can't make it to the reception?
Sure I can, if you cancel your vacation next week. But if you insist on rushing off to see your brother, with all the crowds that are expected to pour in here all this week, I don't know if this is about the only
time. Maggie, I give. Okay.
Listen, I'll catch up with you later. How about when everybody moves to the vault for the viewing, okay?
Good.
Why, continental, the diamonds are a girl's best friend. Oh, Nicky, darling, I believe Mr. Emerson is looking for you.
Oh, Mrs. Dumont, it's so good to see you. If evening wouldn't be complete if you weren't here.
I never miss an opening, darling. Oh, hello, Jeffrey.
I'm going to go to the opening of a door.
Now, may I get you something?
Mrs. Dumont, these are your tapes.
Tapes?
Yeah, the lecture tapes you asked me to record for the diamond exhibit.
Oh, yes, of course. Thank you so much. Oh, Nicky, darling, we'll drop these off at the main desk. Ta-ta for now.
Sweetheart, I'm going to go to Nick's office and finish filing, okay? When you're done with your supper, I'm sure you'll have plenty of homework to do.
I'm going to go to the bathroom, okay?
Fine with me.
Though. Where's my cane?
Oh.
And my cassettes and my sculpting class.
Don't worry about it. I've got them.
Good thing I've got collision insurance.
I bet you're tired from swimming.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give me your attention. Please remain where you are. This is not an emergency situation. Again, please remain where you are. This is not an emergency situation. All stairways and hallways should be kept clear. A police officer will instruct you where to go. Officer
Murray, what's going on?
Someone actually stole the Zertigo diamond.
Mom?
Mom? Everyone, please be quiet. I know this is difficult.
Dad, you finally got here.
Yeah? Maggie?
Look, we have a lot of business to take care of. First of all, determined that the theft took place between 7:45 and 8 o'clock. I need to know where you were at this particular time, each of you.
I was in the receiving line at the party. Nick was by my side the whole time, weren't you, Nicky?
Nick?
Yeah, sure, I was there.
What about you, Sam?
Oh, I was stationed outside the party, Mr. Brenner. Excuse me. And I didn't see anybody come in or go out.
Nobody left that room.
I take it you were there the entire time, Mr. Emerson.
The entire time.
Maggie?
Isn't there a law against this, Jack?
The There's a law against grand theft.
Right. Well, I was in here working. Actually, I was in Nick's office filing.
Yeah, she was. I was in here studying till I fell asleep.
You fell asleep? Terrific.
Jackie was exhausted from swimming practice.
In other words, Jeff, from 7:45 to 8 o'clock, you were sleeping.
Right.
So, Maggie, between 7:45 and 8 o'clock, nobody can vouch where you were.
I see your point.
Jack, have you figured out how this could have happened?
Well, the case wasn't forced open and the alarm didn't sound. So for now, we have to assume that the correct combination of key and voice was used.
Key and voice? Well, that would limit it to either myself, Nick, or Margaret.
One thing we do know for sure, the thief used gloves since no fingerprints were found.
Well, we all wore gloves.
What about evidence? Have you found any clues?
Well, our men have turned up a few things, but I wouldn't exactly call them clues.
Lipstick, glasses, lighter, scarf, and a key.
Let me see this.
Why, that's a security system key, isn't it?
Excuse me. There is a security alarm key, but I'm afraid it's not a key that fits the system I designed.
May I? Oh, Mr. Wong's correct. The keys that fit the Zertigo Diamond exhibit have the museum logo stamped at the top. That key does not.
So I guess it's not important.
Well, we'll hang on to it.
If it would help, I might be able to identify the key so that you could possibly have it traced.
Sam?
Margaret.
Yes?
In light of the circumstances, Margaret, I'm going to have to ask you to take an extended leave of absence until the case is solved. Not that I think you're involved, but for the sake of the museum, you understand.
How long is extended?
I'm afraid I can't hold your job open forever.
This is like something out of a bad movie.
Lieutenant. Lieutenant, as far as I can determine, the key was designed to fit a standard home security system.
Were you able to identify the company that made it?
It would possibly be one of two. It's interesting. The key has an extra notch. That means either train security...
That's hard.
Well, it's not there.
I know I put it back with the other hard.
Matthew, you have that key?
I saw Mr. Wong's hand.
Excuse me, has anybody seen the security key?
We're still wearing them.
The security key we found, Mr. Emerson, it's not in the box.
Well, where is it?
Afraid we're going to have to find out. Ladies and gentlemen, I must ask you all to be searched.
A search? You must be kidding.
Men remain in this room, ladies. Will you please go into Nick's office? Matthew. Find somebody to assist Maggie and Mrs. Dumont. Jeffrey, wait in the hallway.
Dad!
Out.
Yes,
sir. I'll see you soon, son.
How you doing, Ellen?
Beats me how you always know it's me.
Just don't change your perfume.
You're amazing. See you later.
Okay, would you folks follow Officer Lurie, please?
Matthew, who had it?
Did you believe it? Nobody.
Nobody. It doesn't make any sense.
That's what we think.
So what do we do now?
We are ordering a detailed search of your mother's office. You are going home.
Come, I'll show you.
Jeffrey.
One big happy family. Mom is the suspect, the ex-husband is the cop, and our little boy is caught in the middle as usual.
Not exactly the Brady Bunch, is it?
No, not exactly.
Jeffrey, help your mom.
Mr. Wong, is it possible that someone without the key or the right voice could open up the case?
It's not impossible, but it is improbable.
What's up, lunch, huh?
My feet hurt.
Didn't hurt yesterday.
They hurt today.
Okay, Jeffrey Brenner.
Out with it.
Mom, you're the only one without an alibi. They think you did it when I was sleeping.
Jeffrey, if I wanted to steal anything, it wouldn't be that diamond. I hate jewelry. Come on, loosen up. You're acting like your father. Both of you, you're two of a kind.
But if I didn't fall asleep, you'd have an alibi.
Oh, Jeffrey.
All I've done has gotten you into trouble.
Okay, so get me out of it.
Okay, I will.
I was only kidding, honey.
And I'm serious.
Careful, sweetheart, they're hot.
That's weird.
Well, I may not be much of a cook, but I certainly know how to use a toaster.
No, I mean about the diamond. If you didn't take it, and Nick and Mr. Emerson was at the party, and who could have?
If I knew that, I'd be at work.
It was probably one of those inside jobs, you know? Someone must have snuck into your office and stole the key.
Couldn't steal my voice. Here's the juice. Here's the glass.
Someone had to do something.
Well, you're right about that, but unfortunately, like you said, both of the other voices were at the party. You want to tell me how one person can be in two places at the same time? You better get a move on, kiddo. You're going to miss the bus.
No big deal. We're supposed to go to the museum today to see the diamond.
So you're going to get to spend the afternoon in the sculpture garden. I, on the other hand, have to spend the day at the police station. Oh, don't forget you're going to see your father tonight.
Okay, you understand the procedure. I'll ask each of you a series of yes and no questions, and the polygraph will record your body's responses. Is your name Margaret Brenner?
Yes.
Is your name Charles Edmund Emerson III?
Yes.
Is your name Nick Alessio?
Yes. Relax, Nick. These are the easy ones. Were you born on June 14th?
Yes.
That's better. Do you have a son named Jeffrey?
Yes.
Do you work at the South Bay Museum of Natural History?
I'm the director.
Just yes or no, Mr. Emerson?
Yes.
Were you at the museum the night the Zertigo diamond was stolen? Did you attend the press party on the night in question? Did you remain at the reception the entire time?
Yes.
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 In the time period between 7:45 and 8 p.m., were you working in Nick Alessio's office?
Well, yes.
Maggie?
Yes.
Did you steal the Zertigo diamond?
No.
Absolutely not.
Did you steal the Zertigo diamond?
No.
Me, Jeffrey's better, did it.
Can't hear me.
Yes, I can, Barbara. I'm blind, not deaf.
Jeffrey, maybe it would be easier for you if you wait in the lobby.
Thanks, Mrs. Schatzberg.
From the original stone, three large stones and 72 smaller stones were trimmed. The largest of these is the largest cut diamond in the world.
Mom?
In 1907...
Oh, hello, Jeffrey. What brings you here?
The bus. I thought I heard my mom's voice.
Oh, well, you certainly did. I was just erasing the lecture tapes she made for the exhibit. Oh, my goodness. Just look at the time. It's 10 after 2, Jeffrey. Now, Jeffrey, darling, give me your hand. That's it, precious. Now, help me put these cassettes in this box, all right?
Ah, yes. Children, I love to look at them, but I wouldn't want to own one.
Hi, Sam.
Jeffrey, your teacher asked me to tell you that your class is getting ready to leave, and they're waiting for you out front. You better get going, fella.
Oh, thank you, darling. Now, Jeffrey, darling, you wait just a moment there, and then you may escort me out of here.
Can I take your arm?
Oh, please do. Oh, I almost lost my diamond.
diamond?
Yes, darling. See? My diamond brooch. Oh.
Aren't you worried about someone stealing this?
Honestly, dear, I couldn't care less.
You couldn't?
Of course not. My real diamonds are locked in a bank vault. This is merely an inexpensive imitation.
Probably fools a lot of people.
That's the whole idea.
What happened?
Class, I want all of you in your seats and quiet.
What happened?
Some joker ran through the red light. His car's okay, but you see the other guys.
Total?
I said
rear end smashed in.
Mr. Alessio, would you wait by the curb, please? I'll have to write you a ticket.
Mr. Alessio? Nick? Nick!
All right, Jeffrey. It's all around the clock.
Confucius say, growing detectives need good food once in a while.
Jeffrey, I've been taken off the case.
What?
Because of your mom.
But you're not married anymore.
Doesn't matter. The commissioner thinks that it could be a conflict of interest.
So he's letting some bozo run the lie detector test? Oh, sorry. So how'd it go?
Not as well as we hoped.
You mean she flunked?
Well, it's not like a math test, Jeff. You don't pass or fail.
And what went wrong?
Well, probably nerves.
Yeah. They were all nervous. Your mom, Mr. Emerson. Should have seen Nick for a while there. It looked like he didn't even know his own name.
So what happens next?
Well, we'd still like to get our hands on that key. It didn't just get up and walk out of there by itself.
But Dad told Nick the key wasn't important.
No, Nick said that, not me. Besides, the key's very important now, no matter what Nick may think.
I don't think Nick thinks anything. Banged up his car pretty bad today.
Must have happened after I saw him.
Is he okay?
I guess so, except he got a ticket. Can't you guys do something?
Jeffrey, we don't work in traffic division.
I mean with the diamond and Mom and everything.
Hey, listen, Buckaroo. We'll do everything we can, all right?
Okay.
Limericks, commercial jingles, even popular songs are all examples of poetry.
Jeff?
And poetry doesn't necessarily...
Matthew and I are needed at the station tonight.
Does it have anything to do with the diamond?
No such luck. Listen, Jeff, would you like me to drop you off at your mom's, or are you all right here?
Here's fine.
Okay. Don't forget to go to bed.
Have to rhyme. You see, it's not so much how it's written,
hey,
as how it makes us feel.
Take it easy, Slick.
Think about...
Matthew.
Uh-huh.
How come only Mom and Mr. Emerson and Nick had to take the lie detector test?
Well, they were the only three with the right key and the right voice. See, a lie detector test is voluntary. And without any real evidence, we could upset some people by asking them to go through it.
Like Mrs. Dumas?
She didn't even have a key. We all know she talks a lot. She doesn't have your mom's voice. Later, alligator.
Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both and be one traveler.
She does have my mom's voice.
Ladies and gentlemen, the museum is now closing. Please make your way to the nearest exit. The museum is now closing.
I don't know. It's about a couple minutes past. I've got to get that ship delivered to Latin America. Huh? Might be back.
Thank you.
key.
From the original stone, three large stones and 72 smaller stones were trimmed. The largest of these is the largest cut diamond in the world. In 1907, it was purchased by Count István Korhon, who named the gem Zertigo after his family's vineyard. There are many legends surrounding the Zertigo diamond. Perhaps the most recounted of these deals with the estranged relationship of...
What would have happened if Sam hadn't caught you and called me? What in the world did you hope to accomplish by being here?
I thought I could talk to Mr. Emerson about Mom. Someone has to do something.
Jeffrey, you snuck in here after closing. Mr. Emerson was long gone. I'm waiting, Jeffrey.
Mom's voice was on the lecture tapes. She said the code words. Mrs. Dumont had the tapes the night of the opening.
So?
So, I figured she stole the alarm key, snuck away from the party, and used the tapes to open the diamond case.
Flossie Dumont?
She could have.
Flossie Dumont couldn't open up a can of tuna fish. Look, Jeffrey, listen to me, son. As far as I know, the case could only be opened by a human voice, in person. Computer would be able to detect the magnetic hum of a tape recorder. Stay put. You hear me? Just stay put.
Well, I hope I didn't scare you, partner.
What's going on, Sam?
I'm not sure, Mr. Brenner. I mean, I opened the door and knocked over the trash can, and the trash can is supposed to be in the corner near the sink. And you see this window? I'm positive I closed and locked it earlier.
I think we just discovered a way for someone to leave without being noticed.
It's a museum ladder, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
And Jeffrey's insisting that someone chased him before the alarm went off.
I didn't see or hear anything unusual.
Matthew, you found that key in here, didn't you?
Yeah, we sure did.
Sam, you can do voices. If you could do Humphrey Bogart and John Wayne and W.C. Fields, then you could have impersonated Mr. Emerson's and Nick's voice to open the diamond case yourself.
Jeffrey.
Son, I'm just getting over laryngitis, and you remember the night of the opening, I couldn't fake my own voice.
I guess so.
Hey, you kids look like a herd of turtles.
Hey, could you get... sorry, kid, never mind.
Wait, I can get it. Is it in front of me?
Yeah. What is it?
It's a glove.
Forget it then, I got both of mine.
What are you doing?
Installing a new security lock. Look, kiddo, I gotta get this done.
No way, Jose. Your dad ordered this place off limits.
But I came to talk to Sam.
Don't you think you did enough talking last night?
Well...
Well, see you later.
Oh, Matthew, I forgot to tell you. I've got the key.
Key?
Yeah, the fake security key. It was in my backpack. I don't know how it got there, but I used it to open a tape case last night.
You sure couldn't have been another key?
No, Matthew. I'm positive. It was in the plastic bag and everything.
I think it's time we got you home.
You don't believe me, do you?
This has been rough on all of us. Come on, Slick. I'll buy you an ice cream.
And what happens if Mom loses her job? I have to help.
Not as easy as it looks on TV, huh?
Look, Nick and Mr. Emerson were at the party. Dad said Mrs. Dumont couldn't have done it. And Sam had laryngitis.
Even if he didn't, Sherlock, I doubt if he could have opened that case. See, voice prints are like fingerprints. No two are the same.
You mean no two people have the same voice print?
No, not even identical twins.
Great. Maybe Dad was right. Maybe I should leave the detective work to you guys.
Jeffrey.
Don't you know how to knock?
Honey, you can't let this get to you. What you did last night was wrong. Not to mention illegal.
You sound like Dad.
You sound like me. I don't want you to get hurt.
I was only trying to help.
You know what? There is something you can do.
What? Stay locked in my room?
At least I'd know where you were. No. Even though your dad has put the museum off limits, I would appreciate it.
If I snuck in and followed...
No. If you would stop by one afternoon and apologize to Mr. Emerson. Dinner in half an hour.
Cigars. Mr. Emerson. It was you, Mr. Emerson. You stole the diamond.
Young man, didn't anyone ever teach you how to knock?
Someone wearing gloves stole the diamond. You were wearing gloves the opening night. I found this glove here this afternoon. It smells like cigars. You're the only one who smokes cigars.
May I see it? An astute observation, Jeffrey, but it isn't my brand. Smell for yourself. Now smell the glove. Well?
Guess you're right.
Your mom told me I might find you here.
I came to apologize, but I...
Mr. Emerson, I'm really very sorry.
I've heard enough.
Hey, Jeff. Hey, Nick. You're starting to look like Maggie with all that paperwork. Must be quite a strain trying to do both jobs at the same time, huh?
Oh, I tell you, it's beginning to drive me a little crazy.
Speaking of driving, I hear somebody had a little accident.
What are you talking about?
I thought I heard something about you having an accident.
Not me. Who has time?
Must have been somebody else.
Yeah, guess so. See ya.
Matthew. I'm sure it was Nick. Did you know we're being followed?
What?
Yeah, there's a car behind us. It's made the last four or five turns we had, and we just did a circle.
Well, there's a car there, but it's way back. Must have been different cars at different times.
No, it's the same one.
How can you be sure about that?
Because I could hear it. It's the same car.
Look, Jeff, why would anybody follow us?
Someone followed me before. Hey, maybe they want this.
CEE.
Charles Edmund Emerson. It is his glove.
You might have hit the jackpot, Jeff. This could be evidence. Don't you dare say I told you so. I understand. Okay, thank you very much.
All right.
Right again, Slick. The glove does belong to Mr. Emerson. Only it's not one of the ones he wore the night of the opening.
You mean he's got two pairs of gloves?
Believe it or not, he says he brought an extra pair in case the first got dirty.
You believe him?
Well, I'm gonna check it out. In the meantime, your dad took the glove down to the lab for tests. In the sweat stains, we may be able to determine the blood type of the person who wore them. And hey, that's a start.
Weird. It's like the key. But if Nick had the fake key, then who had the real key? Something else. Something else wasn't right.
When an item is valuable as a Zertigo diamond comes to the museum, there are so many things you have to be prepared. You do not want to wait until the last minute.
Still plenty of time.
Jeffrey!
So
what?
For the last 2 weeks, we have done nothing.
I'm on TV. I didn't think they'd bother to run this after everything that's happened.
Indeed, I have seen diamonds before, but may I say that this one is phenomenal.
I hear the security measures alone are phenomenal.
You heard right.
And you ain't heard nothing yet.
I have. One mother's enough. I don't have to sit here and listen to two.
Everybody's a critic.
The last one.
Can I help you?
That's it. Thanks.
Jack, Jeffrey didn't show up for school today.
Where is he?
I don't know. That's why I'm so...
Maggie, calm down. We'll find him. The museum's health insurance forms. They have your blood type on them?
I guess so. Why?
Nothing. Just a hunt. I'll call you as soon as I find out anything about Jeff.
Jeffrey. It's getting to be a bit much, isn't it?
You stole the diamond, didn't you?
What makes you think that? Come on in.
I know you did it.
Look! Jeffrey. I know you're upset about your mom. And we all are. We all want to help. But accusing each other is not going to solve anything.
Nick. I'm blind, not stupid. There were two of you. You have a twin brother. He wore the fake key to the party while you took the real key and stole the diamond.
Well, well, well.
You're really something, aren't you?
What about your car accident? I know you had one, but you told Matthew you didn't.
You're right. You're right, I did. You see, I get my insurance through the museum. I didn't want anyone to find out, so, you know how Mr. Emerson is.
What about the watches?
What about them?
You wear your watch on the right hand. That night I bumped into you, you had it on your left.
Yeah. Yeah, I cut my right wrist. My watch was bothering me, so I just switched it. Look, I'll tell you what. I'm gonna pretend this never happened. I'll call you a cab, and you can be back at school before anyone misses you. Okay? Jeffrey? Jeffrey.
Okay.
I know how you'd feel. I feel exactly the same way. But sooner or later, the police are gonna catch the right person.
I hope so. Sorry, Nick.
That's okay. Yeah, I need a cab, please. Never mind.
Sure is special, isn't it? Even though it did cause all that trouble.